My name's Kerry Russel. I have a master's degree in landscape ecology, and we're going to take a minute just to speak a little bit about forest ecology. So if you look down on the forest floor down here, you're going to see all the species that we've already covered so far. The three-needled fascicle of the loblolly pine along with its cone, and then these leaves belong to a post oak. And then if you follow me up here, you'll see the next species. This is what we call a juniper, specifically an eastern juniper, Juniperus virginiana. A couple of important notes about this tree. One is that most people are inclined to call this a cedar tree, which is a bit of a misnomer. It was a name that was given to it in error many years ago, because indeed a cedar tree is a true tree. It just happens to not be this one. So let's all try to get in the practice of calling this a juniper rather than a cedar. It's an evergreen, just like the pine tree is. It is a conifer or a cone-bearing tree, just like the pine tree is, but the cones on junipers are much, much, much smaller, and they're hard to find because whenever they reach maturity, the whole cone actually dissolves. So in the end, you never really have a pine cone or a cone, juniper cone, left over. We're here in Bastrop, 30 miles from east of Austin. Here, this is an eastern juniper. In Austin, you have a species very similar to this, but the form of it is much different. This one is a much, much taller tree, and the form that you see growing in the Austin area along the Edwards Plateau is called an ash juniper. Much scrubbier, smaller, more rounded, closer to the ground, whereas this one is much taller. So we're still looking at an eastern juniper here, but we've gone over to another individual. And what I want you to notice here are the facts that this is what the young cones look like, kind of very purplish in color. And they're very aromatic whenever you crush them and smell. Even more interesting is the fact that the juniper as a species is said to be dioecious. Dioecious is Latin for two houses, which means that the male and the female reproductive organs do not live on the same tree. Therefore, we have some individual trees of the species juniper that are male, like the one we looked at earlier, which would have pollen sacs in the springtime. And then you have other individuals of the species juniper that are female, that will be the bearers of the cones. This is uncommon in the plant kingdom. The majority of plants are said to be monoecious, one house, which means that trees do not have a gender. They have both the male and the female sexual organs on the same tree, the same plant, the same stem.